Hello everyone! Today we have another selection of news for you. Quarantine ends, everyone starts to bounce back, and interesting news start to appear. In this video, I'll talk about what we have not talked about during the quarantine and discuss two important and frightening news about the Dirugine schools and the non-admission of Irina Wiener. And before the start of the video, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. This year, from May 15th to May 21st, the Viki Festival was held. This is the most popular annual city open air in Russia. This year, in connection with the coronavirus, the festival was held online, and one day on air there was Маргарита Мамун, that talked about how she spent her quarantine at home.
У наши дни ничем не отличаются от дней, которые были до самоизоляции, поэтому скучать не приходит.
То есть вы в обычном режиме недосыпа. У вас прекрасные социальные сети, и в одной социальной сети вы выложили вот такое фото. И назвали это фото «Стоп треники челлендж». Присоединился ли муж к вашей акции, и если да, где он нашел тоже черное платье?
Я бы не сказала бы, что мой муж был в поисках черного платья, и смокинг он тоже не одел. Растянутых футболок и треников в нашем доме не имеется.
Ничего себе! И каково вам быть единственной семьей в России, где нет растянутых футболок и треников?
Мы стараемся ломать систему, но потому что уже просто невыносимо.
Лейсана Тяшева recently gave an interview where she talked about how her new show on YouTube during the quarantine is going. She and her husband conduct online trainings for stars online and make a full-fledged YouTube show out of it. Максим Галкин, Гарик Харламов, Тимати, Антон Шестун.
Руки прямые, заводим немного за спину.
Насколько? Вот так?
Не, Лисан, так только ты можешь. Не, я тоже так могу, но так не надо.
Так не надо.
Рукой касайся ноги, вот так, потянись. Противоположной, вот так, вот. И теперь давай до стопы дотронься, до стопы.
Да вот этого?
Вот этого, да.
Молодец. А теперь руками своими клинтами, пожалуйста, вот так вот. Зацепись о стопы.
Давай,
я верю в тебя.
А мне нужно делать то, что вы делаете.
Да, да. Конечно.
А где Тима? Куда он убежал?
In her interview, a part of the show, Лейсан also spoke about her favorites for the upcoming Olympics in 2021. Her favorites are the Аверина sisters. She even has a dream that girls not only go to the Olympic Games together, but also share the first place there. Well, a funny fact, despite the fact that Лейсан likes Аверинас, she still does not distinguish them. Write in the comments whether you can distinguish Дина and Арина from each other. Ульяна Донскова, who is an Olympic champion and group exercises, participated in a cute challenge. Not everything has worked out, but guys have laughed a lot. Dmitry Kornev, a photographer of the Russian national team, has already shared some photos from the first training sessions of gymnasts of the Russian national team. So far, only Аверина's sisters are in his lens, but I think soon other gymnasts will fill us with materials from the first trainings. The United States Rhythmic Gymnastics Federation has announced the postponement of all sporting events to 2021. So gymnasts this year will not host national tournaments. Perhaps later there will be some intra-club starts, but it's too early to talk about this. All official and important starts have already been postponed. Well, and now we are moving to some unpleasant news. The organization responsible for the medical support of the Russian national teams has put forward a requirement for national teams that prohibit employees over 65 years old from taking part in the training process. This means that the head coach of Russia in rhythmic gymnastics, Irina Alexandrova Wiener-Usmanova, will not be able to attend the gymnast trainings. And when this restriction will be removed is still unknown. Obviously, all the gymnasts have their personal trainers who can practice with the girls in the gym. And Irina Alexandrovna will probably be able to train girls via Skype, as she did in Rio de Janeiro. But the very fact that after the quarantine has been cancelled for the team, the head coach cannot be in the hall is unpleasant and sad, as she cannot fully train the girls. By the way, apart of Irina Alexandrovna, other gymnastics trainers will not be able to take part in the training. Coach Andrei Radienko is 77 years old. Synchronized swimming coach Tatiana Pokrovskaya is 69 years old, and swimming coach Sergei Chepik is 65. Well, And topic of swimming is a separate one, since athletes are not yet allowed to use the poles. So in what form and how effectively do they train is still difficult to say. The next news is no less fun and probably even more sad. Ukrainian gymnasts and the School of Dirugines are evicted from the October Palace. From the 1st of June, gymnasts must leave the gym. Due to the fact that the building is in a bad condition and the school was refused an extension of the lease. An unpleasant moment for gymnasts was the fact that the part in which the school is located is fortified and the rest of the building continues to operate. Now all the gymnastic stars in Ukraine are calling for help. A huge number of coaches and athletes who grew up in the school have already taken a part in the appeal.
З 1 июня виселяють гімнасток із школи владельці Октябрьського дворця спасти школу Дерюгіна. Гімнастика України виросла в этом залі.
Ко всем своим ярким победам я готовилась в Октябрьском дворце, с которого сейчас выселяют, выгоняют юных звездочек и их тренеров.
Я сама выходец из этой школы. Тренировалась у Альбины Николаевны Дерюгиной.
Для нас Октябрьский дворец – это не только спортивный зал, это наша легенда, это наша жизнь.
Из этого зала вышло такое количество чемпионок мира, олимпийских чемпионок, специалистов по художественной гимнастике, которые сейчас работают по всему миру.
Руководство города Киева и профсоюзы должны поддержать и сделать реконструкцию Октябрьского дворца.
We hope that the Dirugina school will not be closed and it will continue its work. And more than one generation of future champions will be grown in there. And Irina Wiener will soon be allowed to train in the gym. Write your opinion in the comments about the latest news and remember that I love you all. See you in the next video and for now, goodbye. The video was translated and dubbed by Alexandra Sinica.